Hi guys, welcome to Total Hypothesis episode 10. I'm your host Chan Wei. And he's your host Edwin. So today we'll be talking about team
DK.
No one knows what it stands for. So DK, yes, DK.
Yeah, nobody knows. Except the logo is actually like a guy holding a sword, I think. If you take a closer look, I think it's a guy holding a sword. I don't know what it is.
Hopefully it's a guy holding a sword.
Okay, the team is led by Burning. A bit of their back end story. Burning actually came from E-Home. Yeah, and slowly became one of the team captain later on. His teammate consists of ROTK, the very famous support hero, but sometimes he play Weaver as well.
ROTK?
Like the
Shanghai.
Sub farmer of it. ROTK initially was from Rising Star, if I'm not wrong.
Rising Star.
That was very long ago. He was from Rising Star. He was being, yeah, he was from Rising Star.
Rising Star
and
in the scene.
I think the DK started off with ROTK and Super being their original member, and Burning was added on later. But subsequently, some issue here and there, and then Burning became the team captain.
And then became Burning and, was, and Friends.
Yeah, Burning and Friends team. He is declared the best farmer as well, I think.
In China.
Yep. The other three member consists of Tai.
Tai.
I think it's a Chinese word. Tai.
Tai.
QQQ and Super. Also, known, some people know him as Yu or something like that. Yeah, but he's Super. As in, his name is Super, he's not Super. Okay, the two heroes that we'll be picking, for me, I would like them to pick up Nyx Assassin, because somehow China team don't really like to play Nyx Assassin, especially DK. They don't like the NA going around.
They don't like the aggressive style.
Yeah, they like to farm and farm and farm. That's why Burning being the best farmer. But
They like to play defensive, I guess.
They like to defend, farm, and farm, that kind of stuff.
Everyone gets their
item. I think, if I'm not wrong, Burning Alchemist in one of the tournament has not lost.
Has not lost?
Yeah, it's a 5-0. Whenever he uses Alchemist, that he will win the game. The team will win with him playing Alchemist.
Burning
is really a good farmer, everybody know that. But I think the spotlight is just on him, not a lot on the support player. And I think that ROTK really support well. Look, like he play Windrunner, he support Burning excellent. Like I mean, NA is a good support hero. He roam around the jungle, he stop opponent from farming and stuff like that. And like
freaks people.
Yeah, like what you say. I think they have to go more aggressive rather than defensive. Cause
maybe
especially international team, like if you play with all the Angmos.
If
you play defensive, they're gonna eat you up, man, trust me.
They are really.
They'll push
but,
right.
But what if their defensive can outplay their offensive?
But you so have
that's
like,
one thing is.
You have Zenith.
Zenith? I don't know.
They play out of the box.
They don't play defensive, they don't play offensive.
Yeah, they play out of the box. That's right. You got teams like that, and you got Navi. Dendi recently going on fire with his pup.
Okay, his play style, man.
Crazy. I really like to see them play NA, Nyx Assassin. I really want to see how they move around with NA being in their lineup.
NA and Visage. I think NA and Visage is strong.
Visage is common. It's very common.
Yeah, it's damn
like, everything is picking Visage.
Super defensive and offensive.
It's like the old Magnetar like that.
Yeah,
it's like Benny or
super strong.
So it's just I would like to see their support play NA. Very interesting. I mean, Burning can pick up NA as well. I don't know.
Well, if you can farm. I just recently played one NA that bought Midas.
Dagon 5.
Near Midas tracks and Dagon 5. Why not?
Why not?
Whatever he wants.
Yeah, that's for my hero. And yeah.
For me, I'll be picking Bone Fletcher. I want to see Burning on Bone Fletcher. I think he's a pretty good carry. Let's just say your team wants to go on the offensive try lane, he's good enough to stay alone at that safe lane. You see, he's pretty much self-sustaining after he reached level 6.
Yeah, true.
And then usually after when he reached level 6, he will at least have an Oblivion stuff or maybe like Ring of Aquila, Soul Ring up, so the mana regen is there. And whenever you need HP, you know, you get to eat the creep.
Yeah.
And then it suits very... I guess it suits somehow into the defensive play where you stay in your lane. Unless someone comes and gang you, true, and then you're most probably dead.
I think if...
even with that dust... Right now, dust have that 10% slow, so I guess it makes a bit... quite a big difference for supposed to buy dust to slow down that Bone Fletcher's wind warp.
So, but I mean, having said that, I think Bone is still quite strong. Like what you say, they just have to babysit Bone until level 6 so the support can start roaming around. Even before that, the support can actually roam.
Then one thing is Bone is good at picking off supports, man.
Especially
when with the Orchid.
Yeah, with Orchid up, it's, and then Shred, the burst damage is like crazy.
Pump, pump, pump.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Everyone's dead.
Bone is a good pick up. But Burning...
But no, there's
melee farm. I see him mostly on melee hero, but not so much on the.
I guess it's like a miracle to see him on.
I think it's quite hard to actually see the team picked up these two hero, but
there are always chances, man.
Yep.
So that's it for this week.
Yep.
We'll see you next week.
And do leave your comment and feedback below. Let us know what you feel about the video.
Anything is fine.
Yeah, you don't answer.